Hello students, for any subjective project you need to create certain charts, scrapbooks or any sheets. For that, heading writing is must. Today I'm going to share the easy three rules to write the heading. First of all, just mark margin lines using a scale and a pencil. All the letters should be in between these two lines so that all letters should be equal. Now, rule number one, we are going to write in print form. It means that we are nowhere going to use the cursive handwriting in heading writing. So let's write a simple word here. Your first letter should be capital, and that is a general rule of language. Let's talk about the second rule, which is bold standing line. So all the standing lines will be bold. Here we are going to focus only and only on the standing line, and we will be leaving the sleeping line as it is. After this, let's move to the third rule, carve to three line letters. First of all, we should know what are the three line letters. We are talking about the small A to Z. For example, if we'll be writing letter A, it comes in between two lines. So that is a two line letter. And B is coming in between three lines, so this is known as three line letters. D, T, F, L and even the G, Z, Z are three line letters. Now rule three, giving curve to the three line letters. Here H, D and G are three line letters, and after giving them curve, same way follow the second rule of bold standing line in those curve line as well. Curve can be given as per your choice. Now you can see that we have started with the print form writing, and this heading is converted into this using these three easy rules. Isn't it easy? Now let's talk about one more trick to make it even more easy. For that, we will be taking two different nibs. If we'll be using sketch for writing, to give it a bold look, let's take a bold marker. And if you want to use the CD marker for heading writing, then use a sketch for the bold work. Now your work will become even more easy with this technique. Now same way, give curve to the three line letters and volume to the standing lines. I hope these technique will help all the students in all the subjective presentations. It will make your project work like your charts, scrapbooks, A3, A4 sheet designing. It will become very easy for you to do with this. That's all for today. I'll be meeting you again with new video related to latest art and craft ideas. Till that time, bye bye and happy learning.